They've been doing questions like this throughout the beginning portions of this unit, but now we knew what they were, though. So we knew it was a translation, we knew it was a reflection, we knew it was a rotation, we knew it was a rotation, we knew what it was. Here, we're just going to say, hey, what happened? So you're going to have to look at these pictures and figure out what's going on. If you're having trouble, sometimes it will help to write the coordinates down so you can look at them, especially if you think it's a dilation, because that's helpful. So, as you go through these problems, take a look at it. If you're not sure, look at the video and see, kind of my rationale behind what I'm doing, because it's incredibly important there. Those are just kind of a review of what we've got going on, in terms of the stuff there. These are also ask you if they're rigid motions. Remember, this is probably pretty easy. So if it's the same size, it's going to be a rigid motion. Same size and same shape, you should know both. Okay, but it's really just the size because the shape never changes. And then if you do get asked direct, that means the letters remain in the same order when you go around the outside the same direction. I always just do clockwise. That's going to be much, much less important. Take your time with these because they do, they can be a little bit complicated, and a little bit later in the unit, we're going to do some of the stuff where there's two of them happening to the same thing, but they're not, like, it doesn't show the middle image. So we have to be careful with these, and then get really good at recognizing, okay, that's definitely a reflection, so that we can kind of pick these things out.